Okay, so let's start with the chapter. In this lesson, we will explore what are programming paradigms and henceforth differentiate between object-oriented programming and procedural programming. So let's start with exploring what are programming paradigms. Well, programming paradigms are a way to classify programming languages based on their features. And there are a lot of paradigms that exist in the world of programming. Two of the most common programming paradigms are object-oriented programming and procedural programming. So let us explore the differences between them. So on the left, we have object-oriented programming. For simplicity, I will call it as OOP paradigm. And on the right, we have procedural programming paradigm. Well, in the case of OOP paradigm, the program is divided into small parts known as objects. But on the right, the program is divided into small parts called functions. And this is one of the significant differences between these two paradigms. Just because OOP paradigm supports inheritance, we can reuse the code to the maximum extent. But on the other hand, since we don't have objects and classes, support for inheritance is absent. So there is limited code reusability. Features like function overloading is supported in OOP paradigm. But on the other side, it is not supported. In the OOP paradigm, access specifiers are supported, while on the other hand, they are not supported in procedural programming. Well, due to that, OOP paradigm is more secure because we can use access specifiers to decide which data should be hidden and which data should be exposed to the outside world. But in procedural paradigm, due to the lack of access specifiers, data is less secured. There is no proper way to hide data. So this makes data to be treated on top priority in OOP paradigm. So data becomes more important than functions. But in procedural programming, since we don't have access specifiers and no proper data hiding mechanism, so we are only left with dealing with functions. So by default, all data becomes public and we need to manage only functions to achieve our objective, which is quite a limitation, isn't it? The languages such as C++, Java, Python, C#, falls under the OOP paradigm. And the languages such as C++, Fortran, Pascal, C, Basic comes under procedural paradigm. So here you can note that C++ supports both OOP paradigm as well as procedural paradigm. That is why C++ is often referred to as a hybrid language. So this might confuse you right now, looking at the differences between these two paradigms. So for the more clarity in the next lesson, we will explore in detail the differences between C and C++ language. See you there.